Field Brothers have the magic touch, from international children's juggernaut The Wiggles to where it all began, the 80s rock band The Cockroaches. Gotta stop my trembling. I gotta do it right. Looking in the mirror. I gotta fix my hair right. Here she comes again. Just hear the boys cry. I feel my heart a thumping. They're singing, come on, come on, come on, come on, yeah, yeah. Hey, let's go, let's go, let's go. Hey, let's go, let's go, let's go. Hey, let's go, let's go. 'Cause she's the one, 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 she's the one.
I still love that one. Yeah, and now Paul Field is bringing the magic to a new music venture for kids, and he joins us today in the studio. Paul, it's great to have you here.
Thank you.
Hi, good to see you.
It's still a belter, that song. I absolutely love it. You and your brother's instrumental to the Wiggles' success. You were the manager.
Yeah.
Whose idea was the skivvies, and how did you get that one over the line?
The skivvies, Anthony actually thought it. They had all different coloured shirts and said, you know, let's get this individual colours, and they literally went into Myers one day and it was a race to get what colour.
So really? Is that how it worked?
There was no focus group. This was just... yeah.
And look, it's like Reservoir Dogs.
Look at the blue all the way back then. It was more a teal shade, you could even say.
Yeah, he was actually green at one stage, and then when Dorothy was green, and then when they were working in front of green screens, they thought, I need to change it, so he became blue.
How come we never saw you in a skivvy pool?
Very good reasons. I don't want to mention waistlines or anything like that, but yeah, you know, there's my dad. Oh my goodness,
it's
it was a family business.
Family affair.
And that's Johnny in the Captain Feathersword. So we work cheap.
Yeah. Well, in fact, your brother John, he wrote the Wiggles classic Hot Potato.
He did.
He's written so many new songs for this new album for Peachy King. So, is there any banger for the kids?
Oh, absolutely.
What do you think the kids are going to go crazy over?
Yeah, I think. Probably the stand... Oh, there's many standout tracks, but Kangaroo, Kangaroo. We've got a guy called Pat Powell who used to be in Club Scar in the 80s. Grew up in Bristol, Jamaican lad, and just has a magic voice. So we've got lots of different singers on the album.
Should we hear it?
Oh, absolutely.
Let's hear it. See, this is what you field boys are so good at, creating songs that kids love that don't drive parents insane. It's a magic.
It's helpful that parents and carers dig it as well. That's true. And Johnny, who wrote over 300 songs for The Wiggles, has written the great majority of songs on with this project. And, yeah, he's very frustrating to have as a brother. He's always got about four great melodies in his head at one stage.
Wow. You
know? He always makes it work, though. And a shout-out, happy birthday to Johnny as well.
He turned 60 yesterday, folks.
There we go.
Wow.
Yeah.
How important is music in kids' development?
Oh, it's like magic, you know, and you'll know with your own children when they grow up. And, you know, little Felix, my four-month-old grandson, he responds already. And when he's upset, they'll sing him... the theme from Elmo's show, and he calms. It's like, wow, you know. And my one-year-old granddaughter, same thing. She really gets taken up. And over the decades with the Wiggles, you'd meet people, children, of course, but all ages on the spectrum, where not much gets through, but music does.
Mm.
And to think cradle to the grave, music's the great thing that can connect you. Yeah, and so much, it's very important for children as part of their life. And I think what we can do is help give them the joy of music,
Huge cast of Australian musos and singers who've worked on this new album with them, Peachy Keen. What are the challenges writing for kids as opposed to writing for adults?
Yeah.
Because you've got to get it right. You've got to get it right, don't you? Because they're pretty tough critics, kids.
That's it, you know, and melody's a big one. And also our audience ranges from a little one on your knee or burping to someone about to go to school. So a lot of the audience is pretty literal. So you need to get them with a variety of beats, melodies, absolutely, and sometimes actions, you know. So you really do need, a spectrum of hooks, you know. But the main thing, I think, is good melodies. And with this project, we wanted the best of the best, so the best sounds. I think we're probably the only early childhood brand that is recording in spatial audio, which Apple Music has created.
What's that?
It's kind of an advance on 5.1 surround. Now, you might ask if a two-year-old's going to recognise that. They probably won't. But it's just, we really wanted to make this the best of the best. So when you hear strings on the album, it's an actual string quartet, that kind of stuff,
oh,
you know? And
wow.
I think that makes us stand out. And Johnny could write jingles, you know, like... There's a different approach. So Hot Potato, for example, his greatest hit, it starts with the chorus. Because, as you know, with little ones, they either dig it or they crawl or walk.
Yeah, they crawl away and draw along with them. Here's a question, Paul. So if you and your brothers were behind the biggest kids band on the planet, why'd you want to create another one?
We've had a couple of years off, as the world may have noticed.
Yeah.
And that's what we do. We're always playing music. We're always making music. And I got in discussions with a guy from Platoon. It's a music company that basically launched Billie Eilish in the States. So you take that call.
That's an important call to take.
And he basically just said, look, what you've done with the Wiggles is fantastic. Could you do something for us? And you always say yes.
Yeah.
And so we created some songs, sent them, and they loved it. So we've already got three albums in the can. This first one, Animal Songs. Debuted at number one on the iTunes Children's Chart.
There we go.
I don't want to drop that in anywhere.
That's fun for everyone to know. That's
so,
incredible.
We've got a lot
Congrats.
Of content coming. Yeah.
Oh, well done. And the kids win out, don't they?
Oh, absolutely. It's great to be a part of children's life music. You know, it helps carers and parents, you know, to feed in the car.
Yes.
Moving around, you know. And we've got a Lullaby album coming out in a month or so. Sleep is a huge part, you know. So
Yes.
Rock
hanging out for that one. Peachy Keen, Animal Songs is available now across all streaming platforms. You could also jump on board and follow Peachy Keen at Peachy Keen Official. Paul Field, thank you for coming in. Can't wait to see
pleasure.
You soon.
It's a pleasure to meet you. Congratulations
Thanks,
on everything.
Guys.
And thank you for everything.
Oh. Yeah. Everything.
Yeah.